Hello students, very warm welcome to scholar.com. This is your Rohan Dangi, your faculty for economy. And as all of you have noticed, we have completed our discussion on 9th class NCERT. In today's lecture, we're going to begin our discussion on the 10th class economy NCERT. We're going to begin with the first chapter, which deals with development. Right. So this is Rohan Dangi again, welcoming you on board to scholar.com for a fruitful learning experience. So let's begin. Yes, so this is the first lecture of class in NCERT. We'll be talking about development in this lecture. So let's begin. Let's take an overview of the chapter, right? So it says that different persons can have different developmental goals, and what may be development for one may not be development for other. It may even be destructive for the other. Let me give you some examples here. I want to illustrate all of this by using certain examples, right? So see, for example, for development, what is most essential for development? What is most essential is the availability of power, right? Electricity. And that electricity is based on fossil fuels like coal and oil. These coal and oil have high carbon emissions. These high carbon emissions lead to global warming and climate change. Because of global warming and climate change, there is a rise in sea levels. Right. So higher the carbon emissions, higher will be the impact of global warming and climate change, and higher will be the rise in the sea levels. Correct. Now you need to realize one thing here is that there are small island developing nations which are very poor. When there's a rise in sea levels, these small island developing nations like Mauritius, like Maldives, like Fiji, like Kiribati, like Tuvalu, they face problems because their land is submerged under water. And as more land comes under water, they have to flee to other areas. These are already poor nations. And majority of the nations which emit a lot of carbon in the atmosphere, they are either developed nations or developing nations, right? So the development of one nation might lead to more and more poverty in another, right? So different persons can have different developmental goals, right? And what may be development for one may not be development for the other. It may even be destructive for the other. And well, I've just now explained to you why it can be destructive for the other as well, right? Ab dekhiye ek baar samajhne wali hai yahan pe that different persons can have different developmental goals. Ye this is a very important statement, right? Development can assume different definitions for different people. Very, very important. Okay, for a person who belongs to the middle class like me, development means timely electricity. Development means availability of cheap and continuous power. Development might mean availability and accessibility of potable drinking water. Right? But for a poor person, development might mean the ability to have 2 square meals per day. Right? Just having adequate shelter. Right? That is development for a poor person. Development for a rich person means swanky airports, the glitz and glamour of the cities, right? Air travel, launch pads, helipads. So depending on whichever class you belong to, depending upon whichever community or grouping you belong to, your ideas of development might change, right? For me, development means good roads without potholes. But for a rich person, development might mean freeways and expressways so that they can drive their supercars on that, right? For a poor person, a road is not important. What is important is hygiene, because they live in slums, and in slums, hygiene is a major factor. So different persons can have different developmental goals, and what may be development for one may not be development for other. In some cases, not always, but in some cases, it may even be destructive for the other. Okay. Ye bahut important hai, right? So, आप एक बहुत ही अच्छा उदाहरण आपके स्क्रीन्स पे देख रहे हो, वेयर यू कैन सी दैट ए रिक्शे वाला इज ड्रॉइंग हिज कार्ट एंड ही इज मेटाफोरिकली ड्रॉइंग ए सिस्टम ऑन हिज कार्ट। तो ये पिक्चर क्या दिखाना चाहता है, किस संदर्भ में है ये पिक्चर? इसमें आपको वो ये दिखाना चाहता है कि विदाउट मी दे के नॉट डेवलप इन दिस सिस्टम, आई कैन नॉट डेवलप। सो दिस इज दिस पर्सन बिलोंग्स टू द लेबर क्लास। वी हैव मेड्स हु कम टू आवर हाउसेस टू क्लीन आवर हाउसेस। वी हैव ऑटो ड्राइवर्स एंड कैब ड्राइवर्स हु टेक अस फ्रॉम पॉइंट ए टू पॉइंट बी। वी हैव प्लम्बर्स, कारपेंटर्स, कॉबलर्स, ऑल ऑफ दिस पीपल हेल्प अस इन मैनेजिंग आवर डे टू डे लाइफ, इन कंडक्टिंग आवर डेली लाइफ, राइट? बट एट द सेम टाइम, सो आर एग्जिस्टेंस इज प्राइमरीली डिपेंडेंट अपॉन देम एज रिगार्ड्स फुलफिलमेंट ऑफ वेरियस डोमेस्टिक एक्टिविटीज आर कंसर्न, राइट? बट वेन इट कम्स टू देयर एग्जिस्टेंस, दे कैनॉट डेवलप इन दिस सिस्टम बिकॉज आर सिस्टम इट क्रिपल्स द पुअर। इट इज नॉट इन फेवर ऑफ द पुअर। फॉर द पुअर सर्वाइवल इन दिस सिस्टम इज की। बियॉन्ड सर्वाइवल दे कैनॉट थिंक इवन थिंक ऑफ डेवलपमेंट। सो ऑल्दो विदाउट ए पुअर पर्सन और विदाउट ए पर्सन हु बिलोंग्स टू द लोअर स्टेट ऑफ सोसाइटी, द सोसाइटी कैनॉट मूव फॉरवर्ड, बट एट द सेम टाइम दैट पर्सन कैनॉट राइज अप इन द सोशल लैडर। दैट वेरी पर्सन हु इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर द सोसाइटी वर्किंग लाइक अ वेल ऑयल्ड मशीन, दैट वेरी पर्सन कैनॉट मूव अप इन द सोशल लैडर फ्रॉम बींग ए पुअर पर्सन टू बींग ए मिडिल क्लास पर्सन, बिकॉज द सिस्टम इज डिबिलिटेटिंग हिज और हर अबिलिटी टू फंक्शन एंड डेवलप हिज और हर ओन सेल्फ, राइट? सो दिस इज द अनफॉर्चुनेट रियालिटी एंड दिस इज वॉट वी हैव टू कंसिडर वेन वी टॉक अबाउट डेवलपमेंट। डेवलपमेंट इज नॉट जस्ट ए नंबर, इट इज नॉट जस्ट जीडीपी ग्रोथ रेट। डेवलपमेंट इज वेदर दैट जीडीपी ग्रोथ रेट, वेदर दैट नंबर इज ऑल्सो रिफ्लेक्टेड इन द लाइफ स्टाइल्स ऑफ ऑल द पीपल एंड नॉट जस्ट द रिच एंड नॉट जस्ट द अपर मिडल क्लास। डेवलपमेंट शुड रिफ्लेक्ट इन द लाइफ चॉइसेस एंड इन द लाइफ स्टाइल ऑफ ऑल द पीपल अक्रॉस ऑल द स्ट्रेटा ऑफ द सोसाइटी, राइट? So this is how you have to understand development. This chapter is very important is because it will give you a lot of fodder for understanding and a lot of what you can say conceptual understanding for writing your essays. Okay, so let's move forward. What development promises? So here in you are in one table you have developmental goals of different categories of persons. So here you see that there are landless rural laborers, right? So for landless rural laborers, what are their aspirations? More days of work and better wages. Local school is able to provide quality education for their children. There is no social discrimination, and they too can become the leaders in the village. So some sort of political independence, some sort of economic justice, and some sort of financial gain is what they aspire for. So we are talking about landless rural laborers. Then you have prosperous farmers from Punjab. What are their aspirations? Their aspiration is an assured high family income through higher support prices for their crops, generally the MSP, minimum support prices, which is determined by the government, which we have spoken about in the 9th class NCERT. Right? And they achieve this through the hardworking and cheap laborers that they employ on their fields. Right? At the same time, they also aspire to be able to settle their children abroad. They want to have as much cash as possible so that they can send their children abroad. Right? If you're talking about Punjab, then you are talking about the Punjabis sending their children to Canada. Right? So there are farmers who depend only on rain for growing crops. Then there is a rural woman from a land-owning family. There's an urban unemployed youth. There's a boy from a rich urban family. All of them have different developmental goals and different aspirations, right? Like a boy from a rich family would want a supercar. An urban unemployed youth would want a job, right? A rural woman from a land-owning family would want to get married at a what you can say later age so that she can complete her education. And a farmer who depends only on rain for growing crops would aspire for a regular monsoon, a well-performing monsoon, right, which would lead to higher income and higher livelihood support for that farmer, right? Like likewise, a girl from a rich urban family, she gets as much freedom as her brother and is able to decide what she wants to do in life. That is what she aspires for, that there should be no discrimination between herself and her brother, right? So that she is able to pursue her studies abroad. That is what she aspires for. An Adivasi from a Narmada Valley, what is his or her developmental goal, aspiration? His or her developmental goal or aspiration is very simple. They do not want interference. The tribal people in India, the Adivasis in India, do not want any interference. They want complete control over the forest produce. They want to conduct and manage their lives in the primitive life, in the primitive style that they are accustomed to. In the name of development, they do not want the intervention of the state or the intervention of the administration. So likewise, developmental goals differ from person to person, as people belong to different categories, right? So as you can see on your screen, a girl expects as much freedom and opportunity as her brother, and that he also shares in his share in his in the household work. No matter, see, the problem with India, ab yahi problem US mein nahi hogi, because in the US the culture is very different, right? There is no discrimination, there is no gender based discrimination. I mean, there is no gender based discrimination, at least at the household level. There might be gender based discrimination at the higher level where higher jobs are concerned, but at a very rudimentary level, at the elementary level, at the family level, there are no there is no gender discrimination. But this problem becomes stark in India, because it doesn't even matter whether you are rich or poor. Even if you are rich, we tend to, since we are a patriarchal society, we tend to be discriminatory towards women, right? There are many debilitating factors which prevent women from realizing their full potential. And why does that happen? That happens primarily because we are essentially discriminating against women. हम उनको बाहर जाने की इतनी सहूलियत नहीं देते. बाहर जाने की सहूलियत देते तो घर आने का टाइम निश्चित कर देते हैं उसका, राइट? हम उनका शादी की उम्र भी तय कर देते हैं. लड़कों के साथ ये नहीं होता. वी डोंट डू इट विद द बॉयज, राइट? सो अ गर्ल, इवन इफ शी इज बॉर्न इन अ रिच अर्बन फैमिली, शी वुड वॉन्ट टू हैव एज मच फ्रीडम एंड अपॉर्चुनिटी एज हर ब्रदर. एंड ऑल्सो द फैक्ट दैट द ब्रदर शुड ऑल्सो शेयर द हाउस होल्ड वर्क. लड़की क्यों खाना बनाना सीखे, लड़की क्यों झाड़ू पोछा करना सीखे, लड़के ने भी करना चाहिए. इट इज नॉट अ जेंडर स्पेसिफिक रोल. द बॉय शुड ऑल्सो स्टार्ट कॉन्ट्रीब्यूटिंग टू द फैमिली, राइट? सो राइट, सिमिलरली टू गेट मोर इलेक्ट्रिसिटी, इंडस्ट्रियलिस्ट मे वॉन्ट मोर डैम्स. सो इंडस्ट्रियलिस्ट के एस्पिरेशन कुछ और होते. क्रिएशन ऑफ सोशल एंड फिजिकल इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर इज वन ऑफ द ड्रीम्स दैट दे एस्पायर फॉर, राइट? बट अब ये होता यही है. यहाँ पे हमारे यहाँ पे केन बेटवा रिवर इंटरलिंकिंग प्रोजेक्ट हो रहा है, ठीक है? आई होप यू नो वॉट इज रिवर इंटरलिंकिंग. इफ यू डोंट नो वॉट इज रिवर इंटरलिंकिंग, काइंडली गूगल when two rivers are interlinked, so that a river which is deficient in water is interlinked with a river which is surplus in water, and then surplus water is diverted towards the river which is deficient in water. So there are two rivers, Ken and Betwa in Madhya Pradesh. So there is a river interlinking project which is proposed, right? Now this is going to have a very positive impact on the industrialists, because this is going to generate a lot of electricity also. But unfortunately, because of that, the Panna Tiger Reserve is going to be submerged. The Panna Tiger Reserve in MP is going to be submerged, and there are many villages also which are going to be inundated with waters and submerged with waters. So on one hand you are ensuring irrigation potential, on one hand you are ensuring availability of electricity, cheap and continuous electricity, but on the other hand you see that people are losing their not only livelihoods but their own lands, their own homes. The tiger would lose its habitat with the submergence of Panna Tiger Reserve. So, जैसे हमने पिछले स्लाइड में देखा था, that development may also lead to the destruction of some other people, right? Right. So, this will lead to vast displacement of people, and these people will have to be resettled and rehabilitated, which again is a very, very taxing job for the government, right? So, likewise, different people have different goals, right? Now, when you talk about income and other goals, what people desire is regular work, better wages and decent price for their crops. See, India is an agrarian economy, right? And more than 60% of the people in India are still dependent on agriculture. So if agriculture performs in India, then wages can be secured, right? And for agriculture to perform, monsoon has to perform, because the agrarian economy in India is largely monsoon dependent. So what people want is not seasonal employment or casual employment. What people want is regular employment where they get better wages, right, which are linked with inflation, and where they also get a very healthy price for their crops and other products, whatever products that they produce. It could be jute, it could be sugarcane, it could be honey, it could be anything, it could be jaggery, right? So income support is important. Safeguarding livelihood concerns is most important, right? Now, apart from income, people also seek other freedoms like equality in treatment, freedom of choice, freedom of movement, freedom of speech, freedom of thought, freedom of expression, equal opportunity, equality before law, right? Freedom to choose any profession that you want. All of these things, which are a part of the part 3 of our Indian constitution, which is fundamental rights. And some things also, which are part of part 4, which is directive principles of state policy of Indian constitution. Right. So people want that as well. See, basically, what are we looking at? We are looking at human dignity. Right. Supreme Court kya kehta hai? Article 21 jo hai hamara, Supreme Court usme kehta hai that, see, Article 21 is about right to life. Okay. Article 21 is about right to life. And Supreme Court has interpreted right to life as the right to live your life with dignity. And you can ensure dignity for people only when you treat them equally, only when you give them freedom, only when they have security, and only when they have respect for others. So these are also the things apart from economic goals that people are seeking in a society. Right. Like, for example, let's take a look at a case in point is a country like Saudi Arabia. Saudi Arabia mein, ab aap dekhoge, it's a very rich country. It's a rich country, and people who are doing menial jobs and people who are doing petty jobs, even they drive cars over there. So such is the level of development in Saudi Arabia. Correct. Now, what you see in Saudi Arabia is that despite a very high level of economic development, people still don't have equal freedom. People still don't have equal treatment, especially women, right? There are many restrictions which are put by the state. And as a result of that, human dignity is compromised in that country. So countries like Saudi Arabia, United Arab Emirates, they have a high level of development, but that development has not translated into human rights. Many a times the state militates against the human rights of people. Now that's not real development. Development is not just economical. Development is not just good commerce. Development is not just a number. It's the state of mind. It's what you can say, or what you can learn, is a quality of life. And quality of life is determined by not just economy, but also by whether you're getting freedom, whether you are treated with dignity, whether there is mutual respect in society or not, right? So even these are some of the other goals that people aspire for in a society. So the NCRT says that it will be wrong to conclude that what cannot be measured is not important. That's also important. Freedom, liberty, equality, that's also important, right? So if you get, like, there's a very good example given in your NCRT. If you get a job in a far off place, before accepting, you would try to consider many factors apart from income, such as facilities for your family, working atmosphere, or opportunity to learn, right? In another case, a job may give you less pay but may offer regular employment that enhances your sense of security. Another job may offer high pay but no job security, and also leave no time for your family. Social life hi na ho shayad aapki. Correct. I'm sorry for that. So this will reduce your sense of security and freedom, right? So security and freedom are also equally important, as we have discussed in previous slides. Okay. Now, how to compare different countries or states? So for comparing countries, their income is considered to be one of the most important attributes. Countries with higher income are more developed than countries with less income. Jaise humne Saudi Arabia ka example dekha, right? USA is also something, is also a country which has a higher income and therefore is definitely more developed than India, which has a lesser income, right? So the inherent assumption here is that more income means more of all things that human beings need. More of the availability of crop, more availability of fertilizer, more availability of grains, more availability of luxury products, more availability of daily products, more availability of fast moving consumer goods, right? And also the fact that the government can also do a lot for the people. Okay. And then we compare the average income, which is the total income of the country divided by its population, total population. So through that we arrive at the per capita income. So I hope that's absolutely clear to you, right? So the total amount of income that the country has, it is divided by total population. Then you get the average income, which is called as the per capita income. And when you get the per capita income, you compare that per capita income. So suppose per capita income of India is around 50,000 per year, per annum, right? Whereas the per capita income in America is more than 10 lakh, correct? So aap dekhoge, the per capita income in America is almost 20 times the per capita income in India. Now these are just hypothetical figures. I'm just taking an approximation. So please don't quote me on that in the exam. Before you go into the exam, please bring out the actual figures, and these figures keep on fluctuating, right? So that was a small bit of disclaimer for you. What I'm trying to tell you is that a developed country like America will have a very high level of per capita income in comparison to India, right? So in the World Development Reports brought out by the World Bank, this criteria, which criteria? The criteria of per capita income is used for classifying countries. Now, aapka home assignment ye hai ki India kaun se classification mein baithta? Is India a high income country? Is India a middle income country? Is India a lower middle income country? Or is India a lower income country? Right? Abhi India ko shayad lower income country se lower middle income country mein laya gaya hai. या शायद उसको डाउनग्रेड भी किया गया है. आई एम नॉट गोइंग टू टेल यू दैट. आई विल एक्सपेक्ट ऑल ऑफ यू टू गो ऑन गूगल एंड चेक व्हाट क्राइटेरिया और अंडर विच ब्रैकेट इज इंडिया क्लासिफाइड एज. ओके. एंड ऑल्सो फाइंड आउट व्हाट इज द पर कैपिटा इनकम इन इंडिया, राइट? सो एक ये बहुत ही इंटरेस्टिंग और एक क्यूरियस केस स्टडी टाइप है. आप देखोगे यहाँ पे इन वन फिगर यू हैव द कंट्री विद रिच एंड पुअर. हियर बेसिकली फोर पीपल आर सिटिंग ऑन टू चेयर्स एंड वन मैन इज सिटिंग ऑन फोर चेयर्स, राइट? सो इट्स बेसिकली द डिफरेंस बिटवीन द बिजनेस क्लास एंड द लेबर क्लास. द लेबर क्लास मेक्स द चेयर्स, बट इट इज द बिजनेस क्लास विच सिट्स ऑन दैट, राइट? सो दिस इज बेसिकली ऑल्सो द डिफरेंस बिटवीन द कंट्री विच आर रिच एंड द कंट्रीज विच आर पुअर. द पुअर कंट्रीज दे व्हाट यू कैन से they, because of their cheap labor, they produce a lot, but it is the poor, rich countries which appropriate the profits, right? The same difference. They say Reebok, Nike, Adidas, these are all predominantly European and American companies, right? But these products are made in Bangladesh, Vietnam, Philippines, and to a large extent even in India, right? But do we get the profits? No. So that's the difference between the countries which are rich and poor, right? And then there are countries with no rich and no poor. So, right, we made the chairs and we use them. Basically, here you're talking about the equitable distribution of resources amongst people, right? So, USSR, China are the countries which have tried to uphold the principles of equality. But zaruri nahi ki aisa hua hi hai, but at least an attempt is there, right? These are called as socialist or communist countries. And this is invariably what happens in a capitalist country, where there is a stark divide between the rich and the poor, right? So countries with per capita income of $12,236 per annum and above in 2016 are called as rich countries. Jahan pe $12,236 per annum ka per capita income ho, those countries are categorized as rich countries. And those with a per capita income of $1,005 or less are called as low income countries, right? तो अब आपका जो home assignment था वो तो इसमें cover हो गया, मगर आपको 2020 के figures भी देखने. So India comes in the category of low middle income country because its per capita income in 2016 was just $1,840 per annum. देखिए कितना कम, right? So the rich countries, excluding the countries of Middle East, जैसे countries like Saudi Arabia, UAE, Kuwait, right? And certain other small countries are generally developed countries. इनको डेवलप कंट्रीज क्यों नहीं कहा जाता मिडल ईस्टर्न कंट्रीज को डिस्पाइट हैविंग अ वेरी हाई लेवल ऑफ इनकम? इट्स वेरी सिंपल, इज बिकॉज दे डू नॉट हैव व्हाट यू कैन से, दे डू नॉट हैव एडिक्वेट लेवल ऑफ ह्यूमन राइट्स, राइट? देयरफॉर दे आर नॉट कैटेगराइज्ड एज डेवलप्ड कंट्रीज, राइट? सो दिस काइंड ऑफ क्राइटेरिया विल हेल्प यू अ लॉट इन आंसर राइटिंग. मेन्स आंसर राइटिंग में आपको बहुत फायदा होगा. जनरल स्टडीज 3 में जहाँ इकोनॉमी के बेस्ड क्वेश्चंस आते हैं या इवन एसे बेस्ड क्वेश्चंस, राइट? सो इन दोज यू कैन साइट दीज फिगर्स, राइट? एंड देन दैट विल अलाउ यू टू गेट मोर मार्क्स, राइट? पब्लिक फैसिलिटीज आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. पब्लिक फैसिलिटीज लाइक मेडिकल हॉस्पिटल्स, लाइक एजुकेशनल इंस्टीट्यूशंस, दे आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट बिकॉज दैट हेल्प्स अ पर्सन डेवलप, राइट? अब यहाँ पे आप देखोगे कि एनसीईआरटी मेंशंस दैट हाउ इज इट दैट एवरेज पर्सन इन हरियाणा हैज मोर इनकम देन द एवरेज पर्सन इन केरला बट लैग्स बिहाइंड इन दिस क्रूशियल एरियाज, राइट? मतलब इनकम ज्यादा है बट लिटरेसी कम है, ऐसा क्यों? सो द रीजन इज मनी इन योर पॉकेट कैनॉट बाय ऑल द गुड्स एंड सर्विसेज दैट यू मे नीड टू लिव वेल. सो इनकम बाय इटसेल्फ इज नॉट कंप्लीटली एडिक्वेट इंडिकेटर ऑफ मटेरियल गुड्स एंड सर्विसेज दैट सिटीजंस आर एबल टू यूज. मेरे जेब में पैसा है, मनी इन माय पॉकेट, बट देन इफ आई वॉन्ट टू गेट गुड एजुकेशन दैट गुड एजुकेशन शुड बी एटलीस्ट अवेलेबल टू मी इन दैट एरिया. सो मी जस्ट हैविंग गुड इनकम इन माई पॉकेट डजेंट मीन दैट आई एम गोइंग टू बी हाईली एजुकेटेड. देर हैज टू बी अ एजुकेशनल इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर ऑल्सो अराउंड मी सो एज फॉर मी टू बी एबल टू लर्न, राइट? सो फॉर एग्जाम्पल योर मनी कैनॉट बाय यू अ पोल्यूशन फ्री एनवायरमेंट. जैसे आज दिल्ली में हो रहा है, कितना पोल्यूशन, राइट? तो दिल्ली में भी रिच लोग रहते हैं बट पोल्यूशन हाई है. सो दे कैन देयर मनी गेट देम फ्री पोल्यूशन फ्री एनवायरमेंट? नो, राइट? मनी कैन नॉट इंश्योर दैट यू गेट अनअडल्ट्रेटेड मेडिसिन, राइट? अनलेस यू कैन अफोर्ड टू शिफ्ट टू अ कम्युनिटी दैट ऑलरेडी हैज ऑल दीज थिंग्स, जहां पे आपको सही मेडिसिन प्राप्त हो, राइट? सेफ्टी और सिक्योरिटी में भी वही चीज होती है. यू वॉन्ट सेफ्टी एंड सिक्योरिटी बट इन सर्टन एरियाज यू डोंट गेट दैट इन स्पाइट ऑफ द मनी दैट यू आर स्पेंडिंग. And in certain other areas, you get that for very cheap, right? So money may also not be able to protect you from infectious diseases also at times, unless the whole of your community takes preventive steps, right? बॉम्बे जैसे सिटी में भी आज आप देखोगे कि डिसीज प्रेवेलेंस बहुत ज्यादा है बिकॉज स्लम डेवलपमेंट बहुत ज्यादा हुआ, राइट? और रादर एक्सपेंशन ऑफ स्लम्स बहुत ज्यादा हुआ, जिसकी वजह से यू विल फाइंड द प्रोलिफरेशन ऑफ इन्फेक्शियस डिसीजेस इन अ डेवलप्ड सिटी और इन एन अर्बन एरिया लाइक मुंबई, राइट? सो ह्यूमन डेवलपमेंट रिपोर्ट विच इज पब्लिश बाय यूनाइटेड नेशंस डेवलपमेंट प्रोग्राम, इट कंपेयर्स कंट्रीज बेस्ड ऑन द एजुकेशन लेवल्स ऑफ द पीपल, देयर हेल्थ स्टेटस एंड पर कैपिटा इनकम, राइट? एचडीआर ह्यूमन डेवलपमेंट रिपोर्ट कम्स आउट विद एचडीआई ह्यूमन डेवलपमेंट इंडेक्स. इसके कुछ पैरामीटर्स होते हैं. इसके क्या पैरामीटर्स होते हैं? एजुकेशन एक इज वन ऑफ द पैरामीटर्स, राइट? इनकम इज वन ऑफ द पैरामीटर्स एंड हेल्थ इज वन ऑफ द पैरामीटर. सो आप देखेंगे कि वेन यू वॉन्ट टू असर्टन द इनकम यू लुक एट द ग्रॉस नेशनल इनकम पर कैपिटा, ओके? वेन यू टॉक अबाउट हेल्थ वॉट यू लुक एट? यू लुक एट लाइफ एक्सपेक्टेंसी एट बर्थ. वेन यू टॉक अबाउट एजुकेशन वॉट यू लुक एट? यू लुक एट मीन ईयर्स ऑफ स्कूलिंग ऑफ पीपल एज 25 एंड अबव, राइट? एंड दैट विल डिटरमाइन योर ह्यूमन डेवलपमेंट इंडिकेटर रैंक इन द वर्ल्ड. इंडियाज रैंक इज वेरी पुअर. इट इज प्लेस्ड एट the 131st position out of 188 countries, okay? Whereas a very small country like Sri Lanka has a high rank of 73, right? South Asia mein Sri Lanka ko chhoda jaye to all the other countries have a very poor rank including Myanmar, Pakistan, Nepal and Bangladesh, right? India mein aap dekhoge life expectancy bhi 68.3 hai, right? So iska ye matlab hua that India has a long way to go forward. In a small country like Sri Lanka, life expectancy is 75. In Bangladesh it is 72. In Nepal it is 70, right? Greater and higher than India, right? So the Human Development Report puts light on the fact that India has a long way to go. Okay. So exam में they can ask you about who publishes the Human Development Report. Prelims में ऐसे सवाल जरूर आते हैं. तो आपको यहाँ पे ध्यान रखना है कि it is UNDP which proposes that. हो सकता है कि prelims में ये भी सवाल आ जाए. Consider the following parameters. Which of the parameters are used to calculate Human Development Index? So in that life expectancy at birth, gross national income per capita and mean years of schooling of people aged 25 and above are the three criteria, right? So please make a note of that and bear that in your mind. Now, what is sustainability of development? See, what is sustainable development? Development which does not compromise the ability of the future generations to develop at the same pace at which we are developing today. So, आज हम कोल बेस्ड पावर ले रहे हैं तो हमने कोल को इतना एक्सप्लॉइट नहीं करना है कि वो हमारे आगे की जनरेशन के लिए बचेगा ही नहीं. वी ऑल्सो हैव टू मेक श्योर दैट वी गो फॉर रिन्यूएबल एनर्जी सप्लाई सो दैट कोल इज अवेलेबल फॉर फ्यूचर जनरेशन ऑल्सो. सो डेवलपमेंट विच डज नॉट कॉम्प्रोमाइज द अबिलिटी ऑफ द फ्यूचर जनरेशन टू डेवलप एट देयर ओन विल दैट इज कॉल्ड एज सस्टेनेबल डेवलपमेंट. सस्टेनेबिलिटी ऑफ डेवलपमेंट इज कंपेरेटिवली ए न्यू एरिया ऑफ नॉलेज इन विच साइंटिस्ट इकोनॉमिस्ट फिलोसफर्स एंड अदर सोशल साइंटिस्ट आर वर्किंग टूगेदर राइट. सो वॉट एवर दैट यू सी ऑन योर स्क्रीन यू कैन जस्ट पॉज द वीडियो एंड यू कैन मेक अ नोट आउट ऑफ दिस. ओके दिस इज एवरीथिंग दैट आई हैव ऑलरेडी एक्सप्लेन टू यू. यू कैन टेक एन एग्जाम्पल ऑफ ग्राउंड वाटर इन इंडिया एज वेल. सो विद दिस वी हैव कम टू द एंड ऑफ द फर्स्ट लेक्चर ऑन डेवलपमेंट. इन द नेक्स्ट लेक्चर वी विल बी टॉकिंग अबाउट more such issues concerning the 10th class NCERT. So till the time we meet next, this is Rohan Dange signing off from scholar.com. Thank you. Take care. Keep practicing social distancing.